Welcome to Inside the U, episode 3, season 5.
Technically, well, isn't it episode 4 since we did a pre?
That was episode 0, dude.
We're on, we're on season 5, Jerry.
Yeah, but I'm saying. Fine, 0, 1, 2, 3. Fine.
There's the preseason pod.
Episode 3. You know what's funny? I have episode 3 right here, too. Season 5, episode 3.
1 year anniversary.
Jerry's happy.
Of episode 3 of season 5. Dude, I'm so tired.
No guests this week.
No guests.
Nah. No guests. We wanted to do like heavy league stuff.
Yeah.
Have plenty of time to do that.
We're going to deep dive.
But first?
Yeah. First, welcome to Inside You, the ultimate adult hockey podcast. Each week, we're bringing insider topics, special guests, and slight entertainment from the world of adult hockey, along with discussions and updates around the ultimate adult hockey league. I am Larry, joined again by the commish and Mr. Dusty Beaver.
Hey.
And this week, we are back with all the fun stuff, including Summer Showdown. We are past the quarter mark. Well, technically, by the end of tonight, we will be past the quarter mark. So we're diving into league updates. We'll go through the standings, stat leaders. We'll check out this week's game of the week, look ahead to the next one, all the usual stuff. But before we get into all that, just want to ask you guys to continue to drop comments, give us feedback, share the show when you see fit. Quick reminder that something as small as sharing this episode can quite literally contribute to growing the UHL as a whole. So, anyway, with that being said, happy Friday, boys. Game day for you guys.
Yep.
Yeah.
I wanted to ask something. Who do we got winning the cup?
The Rangers. Easy.
Okay, well,
done. Well, that's not happening.
Done.
Yeah.
They'll come back.
So, personally, I like the Panthers. I used them in Chell. I said that last week.
Yeah.
And so, I kind of, like, I'm not, I don't follow the NHL super close.
Nah.
But I do know everybody on the Panthers because I play,
you
know, NHL with them. But, I want the Oilers to win.
Yeah.
Because I like when great players get rewarded.
Mm, fair.
I like that. I like Luka in the finals.
Yeah. Let's go.
I think that, I mean, Boston's had an easy run, so I think Luka can win. But anyway, back to hockey. I want to see McDavid win, you know what I mean? He's like, he kind of carries the team, and him and Draisaitl and a couple other guys, but...
Yeah, I was like the Oilers, too. I was like playing with the Oilers in Chell, actually. That was usually my team.
Well, I've
seen some rumblings about Dallas. Code,
dude.
Dallas.
When was the last time a Canadian team won?
What?
Not Rangers won.
I used to use them
early in 90s, huh?
12.
Yeah, Montreal won in what, 93? 93?
At some time.
I think it's, or no, it's either right after the Rangers or right before, I forget. Because the Penguins won two.
I thought the Devils won right after, didn't they?
I don't remember. Canadians won sometime. But I hope the Oilers win. You know, no disrespect to Dallas. They're always good, but they're kind of just boring, dude. And I like fan base. Like, you see the Oilers games, and they have fucking thousands of people outside of the arena, dude. Like, they're going crazy.
Every time I see, like, Dallas, the highlights of Dallas, like, the stadium looks lit.
It is, but it's like, that's not exactly like a hockey hotbed. You know what I mean?
No, it's not.
Neither is Florida. So,
yeah.
You know, I don't want to see the Rangers win just because of Jerry and because it's the Rangers. And once the Flyers are good again, we'll go back to hating the Rangers a lot.
Yeah.
Sure, because there'll be some level of rivalry, I'm sure.
I'll be honest, like, I feel like the Rangers are the team that I felt the most good about for a long time.
They are just, they can't keep up with the Panthers, man.
Panthers are good. Dude.
They're freaking, they're good.
Deep. Yeah.
They're really deep. That's why I like them in NHL. They're good all.
Yeah, they're beating them
top
in
three lines.
Yeah.
Every category.
Yes.
It's crazy.
Yes. And I like Bob.
So you got Oilers you would like to see win?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For sure. Oilers-Rangers would be a great cup final.
Yeah.
Even go Rangers.
Oilers-Panthers, too, because they're just, you know.
I feel like I would be, like, on the if I were to pick who I wanted to be, the Panthers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I just think if McDavid gets an opportunity in the Stanley Cup final, he's just going to go off, dude. Like,
he's already going off.
Yeah, but he's going to take it up to that fucking... You got your 100% level, and watching him play like that is just crazy to watch.
Yeah, bro.
He's like so. Watching him practice is like you're like zoned in. Like the guy is like how hard he works, and I'm like, you're so good already, dude.
Yeah, well, obviously, when you combine like that talent with the fucking mental, locked in, you know, like. And good, hard work.
Good captain, too.
Yeah.
He's a very good leadership. Captain.
Still think the Rangers are going to win.
Nah. I think Panthers are going to win, and then I hope the Oilers pull it out. But Dallas is really good, too.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. Speaking of locked in, I had a nice open hockey session today.
You went today?
10 a.m.
Did anybody show up?
we had a nice like 3-on-3 half ice, which is always a lot of fun. Yeah. If you have the right, if you have a good group of guys.
Two tendies?
One tendy, so it was take backs. But that can be fun if you have a good group of guys. Of course, it was like, you know, four guys on each side, so we did 3-on-3 with one sub.
Any
hard. But I was saying before, it's just the usual open hockey guys. But you know, I was saying before, if we had UHL games at 10 AM, like
You'd be sick, dude.
Yeah. I would be a problem.
Yeah. Playing at night's tough sometimes, but
yeah. It's no excuse, but you know, that midday focus is different.
It is, you know, for sure.
You gotta like try to ramp up at night.
I'm kind of disappointed there were no Hawks there.
What?
After what we're going through.
No Hawks there.
No one's
putting Tucci's been absent, MIA. I don't know where he's at, but
he's working.
The market golfs every Friday.
It shows.
Yeah. I haven't seen Bascal in months, I don't think.
That makes sense, too. I haven't seen him either, dude.
Hawks in shambles, right?
Hawks and we'll bounce back. We did this last season, too.
We do it every season, dude. Maybe start off 0-3, like, the past 3 seasons.
And we'll have, like, rough patches and stuff. But, you know, we're always there at the end.
Yeah, the games were closed. I don't know. But anyway.
We'll get into the game of the week later, but I was doing some scouting with Rain City and Blue Chew. And they're pretty good.
They're pretty good, dude. Yeah, they're going to be the top. Yeah.
Quick update on the Chell debacle from Crawl Daddy Saves. NHL versus mode is basically who can defend the glitch goals the best, which it's always kind of been like that.
Yeah, it's been like that. Yeah. I feel like there's.
He said it's a bitch move doing them.
That's which what is I fair, said, dude. Yes,
but I also didn't know what I was doing was a glitch goal.
It's not a glitch goal per se, but like
problem. I feel like that's the only way to score.
It's not. The problem is that if you don't have the... So I'll switch my defenseman. See, I like being... I always take control of the defenseman.
Yeah.
That's, but once they're in the zone, I have to switch to the guy in front of the net.
Yeah.
Because they're going to just send it across the ice. So you have to sit there and just defend and let them do whatever they're doing. And it just sucks, dude. It just, like, you're just trying to defend that thing. But there are, like, if you come across... No offense, Leonard, but you come across, like... I don't want to say like good players, but like players who play a lot, they will turn away that opportunity.
Yeah,
and it's like an unwritten rule while you're playing. It's like you kind of judging each other, and then somebody tries it, you're like, all right, fuck you, then I'm gonna do it too.
I feel like every single NHL. I mean, I've played probably 20 of them. So
yeah,
but that's just like the main way to score.
Yeah, I like I doing know. The only thing I'll do a version of, and that's I found works really well. Is do you remember that? It was the Western Conference Finals. I think it was Kings and Blackhawks. And Taves came up the left wing and passed it to Patty Kane, who had his like a one-timer from the top of the circle that went in.
Yeah.
Like, so he came in and came, and it was like the most beautiful. The one where he got on his knees and he did the fucking thing.
Yeah.
I do that in NHL. And that's like respectable because you're shooting from a distance, but like it works, dude.
Unwritten rules.
It works, dude.
Cause I don't know if you ever play that World of Chell mode. It's so fun. Yeah. It is so fun, it's very glitch goal. Like, it's not really like.
It's not fun yet because there's guys who are rated like
fucking
90 well, something. You're like a 70.
And it's like, it's not. Whatever, it's full of glitch goals and just like exploits and stuff like that. But I still find it fun for some reason. I don't know why. I enjoy it.
It's just they made things so much easier.
Yeah,
like they used to have the skill stick and like it would actually take skill to use it. Yeah. And now there's like a controller mode where you can just hit one button and do whatever move you fucking want.
Yeah, it's like dude, that's I don't so even bother weak, with dude. That.
No, I use their old.
We got a live stream the next matchup, Steve versus me.
Do it.
Well, I told you I was talking to Shuksta and I'll set up the Xbox in here and we'll have on the podcast. We'll play like a little 3-on-3 or something.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah. We could probably record it before, then I'll edit it into the pod just in case. But like, we'll sit here and we'll do that.
He streams, right?
Yeah. He could always stream if he wanted to, but we'd have to set some things up.
You got
to
do something. We got to figure something out.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
You going to set up Chell in here?
Yeah. I'm going to beat him so bad, dude.
Yeah.
He doesn't know what he's getting into, dude.
All right, let's go.
I'm getting better.
Love it.
He
said he's going to score nothing but glitch goals on you.
I know. I wouldn't be surprised.
You're going to have to defend it.
Yes.
All right.
Ready?
Let's do it.
Are you ready?
All right. Don't frown. It's time for Summer Show.
All right.
He's been waiting 10 minutes to say that.
And then he'll disappear for the next 50.
Yes.
Don't frown.
He had that queued up.
Love it.
All right, dude.
All right. So this is a family feud style competition between the two of you. I will be the host. And a loser of you two We'll have to do something for each other. The community will vote. And most important thing about this little bit, the loser, you know who's not going to be?
You.
We'll find a way.
It won't be me. We're going to find a way. All right, contestants, are your buzzers ready?
Wait. Some sleeves on, what if we tie? Then you're the loser.
We'll do an extra one.
Oh, gee, of course, he finds, you know. Are we ready, dude?
Are your buzzers ready?
I'm ready, dude.
All right. So, per UHLHockey.com,
nice.
Out of the teams that still exist today, that's important, what are the top five 2023 regular season most winningest franchises?
Oh, you got the last word.
Rain City.
Rain City is number one. Yes. So you have control of the board. So would you like to pass?
Are we doing top five?
Top five.
I'll take it. I can do this.
Yeah. Okay. Winningest? What does that mean?
From 2023. So summer, regular season. Mm-hmm. Summer, fall, winter, summer, fall seasons. So, regular season.
So not including this year.
Does that mean highest winning percentage? That means
just most winnings. How many games they won.
Okay.
Oh.
Most wins. All right, so you're taking it.
Yes.
For 2023. Not yes. Not this year.
Yes.
Okay. And.
Oh, shit.
Most wins?
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to say 24-7 just because even though they weren't around.
So 24-7 is number five.
Let's go.
I'm blocking it from you.
I'm just confused. Most, what are you confused about? Most wins.
Most wins.
Since when? Sorry.
2023.
2023.
So yes. Winter 23, summer 23, fall 23. Last year.
So the most wins.
Correct.
Okay. Sorry.
In all three.
All right, I'm sorry. Combined. It's kind of weird. Most, we've had a lot of teams come like on late.
Exactly. That's why you have to think about it. It's regular season, most winningest franchises. All right, go.
I want to be a homer right now.
What are you looking at?
Just the teams. I can remember. I want to say the Hawks because I know we played three seasons and we usually get like probably like 7 or 8 wins.
Yeah,
and that's pretty consistent.
We're gonna have to. Are we allowed to look at the teams?
Yeah, right there.
Yeah, why not?
I mean, you really shouldn't. You should.
I was gonna say, what's going on?
You really shouldn't look at the teams. But all right, come on.
All right.
10 seconds.
All right. I'm gonna say the Hawks. Got to be on there.
Hawks are number three.
Let's go, baby.
So I'm gonna tell you guys. I'll tell you guys after. Okay.
What do you tell? Tell after what?
Nothing. Keep going. I'm going to do stats, and I'm going to tell you guys what the total wins. I did the top 10.
Okay. I'm gonna go with a rusty team.
Okay.
I was thinking the same thing.
The Wolves.
Yeah.
They got to have a bunch of wins. Damn. No?
No,
I was thinking that.
What?
Because they only have two seasons. They are in top 10, though.
Ah, you bitch. Yeah.
So
I got 1, 3, and 5?
1, 3, and 5. Larry has to get one.
I just have to get one.
To win. Correct.
Wait, one to win?
Yep.
Yeah. He steals it, huh?
He steals it.
Damn, I think I know who it is, too. And I did. I chose.
There's a couple, bro.
I chose not to say it because I thought. I swear the Wolves, because
they only had two seasons,
but they probably had what?
That's why they
20
made.
20 wins?
They ended in the top 10. I'll tell you who's in the top 10.
I like the Hawks are 3.
I'm going to be pissed if I don't fucking get this. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say Night's Watch.
Fuck. That was what I was going to say, dude.
Night's Watch or number four.
God damn. I was going to say it, dude.
All right. Do you guys? Okay. So Larry wins.
I feel like the Chuggernauts are fucking up there. Like someone.
Otters, I feel like.
Otters could be.
Otters are top 10.
Top 10, really?
Mm-hmm.
So let me tell you, 3, 4, and 5 mm-hmm. were tied. 3, 4, and 5 were tied with the most amount.
I was gonna say Rusty Wolves too, actually.
Well, yeah, Wolves are. Yeah,
I guess it was only two seasons.
Mm-hmm.
Sheep.
I thought
Sheep Hockey. Sheep Hockey's number two.
Okay,
yeah. I thought
that.
So it goes with the current teams. Rain City has 27. Sheep Hockey 26. Hawks, Night's Watch, and 24/7 all have 21.
Not bad.
Yeah.
I said 7, dude. That was my thing. I was like, they had 7.
Tied with 24/7, easy.
Easy.
Yeah, but
extra season.
Yeah, just an extra season.
Night's Watch was what I was going to go with, but then I was like trying to remember if they ever had any off seasons.
No, they didn't.
And I don't think they did.
They didn't.
Rusty Wolves were on a run of
So they had, listen, Night's Watch had 8 in winter, 8 in summer, and 5 in fall.
Yeah, I knew they had an off season.
So let me tell you. Now, the top 10, all right, and this is crazy. Number one, Savage Monkeys.
What do you mean one?
And they were number one. 28.
I thought you'd
rank I know, no, no.
He said that now I'm still
giving
active.
You, yeah, now the game was still active, but now I'm just giving you the
that
top
That is kind of crazy.
That's crazy. Well,
that first season, they won.
They won 11. They won. They won 11, summer 9, and a fall 8.
Yeah.
It's crazy, right?
All right.
All right. So Rain City was technically number 2. So I'm going just all of 2023, right? Sheep with 26. Dexter, 26. Mm-hmm. Hawks, 21. Night's Watch, 21. 24/7, 21. Otters, 20. Mm-hmm. Trash, 18. And the Wolves, 18.
Nice.
Trash. Yeah.
So that was
Trash has two good seasons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. Winter and spring, summer of last year.
Yeah. Trash?
Trash.
Yeah. 9-6.
Yeah.
Wish I'm leaning away from the mic.
So that's it. So Larry is up.
All right.
So let's go to bits.
I accept it. I need to go with my gut.
Yeah, you do.
I need to go with my gut.
You second guessed it.
Wolves. I would have guessed Wolves as well.
Week 3. Larry.
Let's go. What am I up? 2-1?
2-1 right now.
That's okay.
Summer showdown.
Summer showdown. That's it.
So speaking of summer showdowns.
I only got to do this once.
All right. I think you need another buzzer because that doesn't.
Even one that hit. Says.
Yeah, I know. I gotta buy one.
Are you familiar with the board game Taboo?
Yeah. It doesn't have the one with the giant. It has like an X.
Oh, it's got the buzzer just goes like obnoxious as that. Hell. Yeah.
I'll get that.
Okay. Larry probably has
You one probably got it. I was going to say, you probably got it buried in your basement something. Yeah. Everyone has Taboo buried in their basement for some reason.
I don't know what that
great,
is.
It's a great game. It's a great game.
Board game?
Mm-hmm. It's like a...
It sounds familiar. Like a board game. It's fun. I probably played it.
Isn't it a trivia game?
It's like you have to get someone to guess the word that you're looking at using like context clues. It's a lot of fun.
I don't know.
When you're drinking some wine and chilling with the family.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah,
so. All right. Anyway, speaking of summer showdowns. Not really, but this week's episode of Inside the U is presented by UHL Events and BioSteel.
Let's go.
As you all know, at this point, if you don't, pay attention. Summer Series 2024 and the UHL Experience presented by BioSteel is coming to the Atlantic City Skate Zone on June 21st through the 23rd. So a quick registration note, there is one spot remaining in each of our Tier 1 and Tier 2 divisions.
Yes.
Everything about it suggests going and securing your spot today. And whether you're joining us on or off the ice, we have a block rate set up with Resorts Casino for discounted room rates. And for the players, we set up a shuttle service to the rink with bag storage, so you have nothing to worry about over the course of the weekend.
Yes.
So go grab your team spot, book a room, and check out the Summer Series trailer with the link in the description. We'll see you on a few weeks. I feel like you both got shit to say. So
no.
Oh.
I do.
I know you do.
All right. So we're missing one spot for Tier 1 and one spot for Tier 2. Now, I can easily put together a free agent team or put together a Hawks Tier 2 team or whatever. So we will fill out the tournament, no problem. I would rather not have to do that.
Yeah.
So I will – we're kind of kicking this around like literally 30 seconds before started. But
yeah.
If you do have a we will do a sort of a finder's fee.
Yeah.
Right? Or what is that? Is that what it is, right? Finder's fee?
Yeah,
right?
Finder's fee.
So if you do referral, something like that.
Yeah.
If you do lead us to filling out those spots, so if you have friends in other leagues or whatever, or a team that's on the fence, we will do, I don't know, $200.
we jumped around like a bunch of different numbers. So.
$200.
Yeah. You have to email Steve with the captain CC'd on the email.
Yeah.
That's how you get it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. I don't really care how you do it, but like that'd be nice.
Because anybody can say like, "Hey, I sent him your." I don't know.
Whatever. Exactly. So maybe $200, maybe something more. Maybe we'll do a stick again from Cutting Edge, but I got to get permission for that.
Yeah.
So
pending,
we'll definitely have. It'll be at least a $200 to $400 value, maybe. So it's somewhere, I told you 30 seconds before we started, dude.
I know.
Regardless, it's fucking. It's what's it gonna take? You like 20 texts in your life? You know, for $200.
Shit, $200. Find a team.
Yeah,
you probably get something together. Everybody plays everywhere. They probably have some ideas.
I just thought about something too. If we do end up having to do a team UHL,
mm-hmm.
we have a lot of free agents. So
I can easily fill that out. Yeah, I have like a bunch. I think for that, at least for Tier 1, I could literally just put out like 8 players like off like that are ready to go.
Ready. Yeah.
So, but like I said, I'd rather, because then I'm gonna deal with jerseys.
Rather get an organized team.
I don't have time to. To organize that. I mean, I will make time, but I'd rather not have to. So, we'll do like a little referral fee or whatever. If you're existing, even if We can also do, if you're an existing team in the tournament, we'll reduce your tournament fee,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
So
don't be shy. Let us know if you got someone.
You'll get a discount for that as well.
Sweet.
No rusty teams.
If I bring in Hawks Tier 2, I'm taking $200 out of the UHL account, dude.
It's fair enough. Fair enough.
I already embezzle everything anyway.
Shut up, dude. IRS, if you're listening.
What was I going to say? When threes series, dude? We should do like a threes tournament series.
I know, dude. Why does everybody keep saying that? I want to do rust. We're going to do a rusty threes. We've been.
What do you mean? Why does everyone keep saying it? Because we haven't done it in fucking
a year, dude. But there's. Yes, I know. We got to do it. I want to do a rusty.
It was just an idea.
I want to do a rusty
one. The reason I bring it up today is because I've been consistently brainstorming about our free agents. We get a lot of free agents. We get at least 10 a week.
Yeah.
Okay. And what I would really love is to give them, because it's difficult to place players on teams throughout the season because your team's full.
Yeah.
If anything, you need guys at the beginning of the season to fill out your roster. So,
correct,
yeah. I just want to find something. Yeah. Like, yeah. Even if it's randomized per division, I assume these guys are pretty honest about what the division they play in. But just some sort of like, well, the division that they fit in.
Yeah,
maybe. I would assume 80% of them are honest, or at least trying to be honest, whatever.
Yeah, I'd say about 80%.
Either way,
correct.
Either way, it could be something where, yeah, like, I don't know about draft or whatever it needs to be, but some sort of like series where the free agents are not only skating, because we can get guys from the UHL that'll want to play too. So they'll get a chance to play with free agents, and it's just a better way to keep people engaged.
Yeah, I mean, even with Rusty, we have 9 Rusty teams. Like, threes tournament, you need 6 players and a goalie. Like, you exactly. guys, they can get yeah, 6
we
players
could,
and a goalie.
I think we could fill it out. It's just, I don't feel like doing the work, so.
Come on, dude.
I was just.
I'm just kidding. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Okay.
I was a joke. I just don't want to. I don't want to. Like I said, we get a lot of free agents, and I just want to make
sure.
You
guys both went silent right
now. Because I was talking about more work that I want to do for these guys, and you're saying you don't want to do the work.
Yeah.
No. I just think it'd be cool to give them something because I don't want them to think we forgot about them.
Who? Well. The free agents?
Free agents.
Free agents.
Yeah. We get consistent
and Rusty too. Both.
Of course, yeah. But the thing is, we put 2 free agent teams in for the summer.
I know.
So it's like
I know.
At the beginning of every season, I send out emails to all the free agents and we create teams. So what happens with we do get a lot of free agent emails, but then people don't respond.
Yeah, I know. Well, this is what I'm saying is I want to keep them in touch and engaged and give them even still it's like you kind of like showcase them like you get course. A chance people can come and like you know what I'm saying and we're getting a lot I guess it's because it's the summer but a lot of gold and silver level bronze course, plus level like guys that have played youth and college hockey like I just feel like we can figure something out as far as like a separate branch of league play you know what I mean mm-hmm.
So yeah once
U3s
yeah once
yeah you, like fuck I think
once sick. We get settled in mm-hmm. like for summer series and that's set we have checking for charity after that, but like July is kind of wide open. Got a bunch of shit.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, so I feel like July we could, aside from the All-Star game, but like I think July we could squeeze in a Rusty Threes on a Saturday.
That'd be sick.
Or a Sunday. It was a lot of fun. One day it is. I just want to play too, so I'm like, kind of, maybe we'll do like a Rusty and a bronze something, you know? Because some people have said it, they're right. Like we have tournaments and they're usually A and B level.
Yeah.
But that's where most of the players are. Like that's where
where the interest comes from.
Yeah, I mean, it's not like we don't try to have other divisions. It's like we don't get enough teams to register for those other divisions. Mm-hmm. So, which I'm not sure why, but
I don't know why either. I would love to see like a bronze tournament.
Yeah, we have the most teams in bronze, dude.
Yeah.
So yeah,
and we'll even a rusty tournament too. But
plus threes is
a little bit
cheap. It's
fun. It is. Yeah, I feel like a tournament for rusty. Some rusty players can be intimidating. Too.
Just do one day.
You know what I'm saying? But yeah, threes would be sick.
Threes is perfect. Yeah. A 1 day tournament.
For one day for perfect, threes. Yeah. Dude. How many teams? Let's just say.
I think what did we fit like 8 last time?
But it wasn't just one day, was it?
Six. It was one day.
But I don't know.
Really.
I don't remember.
It had to be one day. It had to have been at least 4 per division. We had 2, so there's definitely 8 teams.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so we do 25 minute running clocks.
Yeah.
And then we just, everyone's kind of just, a lot of people stay dressed, dude. Because like, their game would, but doing it at Holiday was nice because you can hang out,
go get food. Yeah, you don't have to go far.
Everyone had so much fun.
I mean, you said it when we first like created it. It was like just one day, bang.
nice and easy. It's easier for players because they don't have to dedicate a whole weekend.
Exactly.
They don't have to do, you know what I mean? It's all one day. I think it's easy on us too because we get it all done in a day. It's a long day. Yeah, by the time the finals came around, everyone's like
dying out. Yeah. I feel like we could just create some sort of like series out of it too, you know.
Mm-hmm. We could do
like not the obviously.
I would love to do a series of, even if we, so like, I'll use Rusty for example, right? So we'll have multiple threes, maybe even two threes tournaments, and the winner of each tournament will have like a full blown, you know, we'll figure something out.
No, that's what I'm saying though. Maybe like we can do like champion tournament. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like we can start to create a little more for the next one. Yeah, exactly. Like I think
maybe we can hold off for the fall too, because there's no tournament in the fall because we have the Winter Classic. Yeah. So I think it would fit in better in the fall.
Yeah.
Because there's no tournament there. So because we have to focus on, you know, the Winter Classic, Summer Series. And then it's tougher on in the summer, too, because a lot of people go away and stuff like that. I think fall, everybody's there. There's no tournament. It's a perfect spot to squeeze in.
But fall ended up being, like, kind of tricky, right?
Yeah. It's tough with the ice. Stuff. Yeah.
Eagles games. But threes?
No. So, like I said, Saturday's it's on Saturday, so we're fine.
For threes, but it should be fine.
Honestly, I'll open up registration.
Halloween.
But hold on. We can open up registration for July. And honestly, if it doesn't fill, then we just won't do it. Like, I don't, it is what it is.
We could call it like Hollow Threes.
That's everything we do.
Oh, now he comes alive, dude.
Yeah. Let's go.
Now he's cooking. There we go. Yeah, we'll do that. I'll just open up something and then we'll figure it out from there.
Cool. Yeah. And I keep saying it too, but a little bit of evaluation before you put together your free agent teams and stuff like that. Like, we have a better idea of who people are, you know.
Yeah.
A little something.
We could always like compile how many free agents we have for a specific division and then do that tournament for that division and put together a free agent.
Yeah. Because as long as they're still interested, we can keep in touch with them and give them something to.
I think you guys underestimate the response back.
No, because you wait a whole season before you reach out to them.
No, not necessarily.
So when you fill out a form and then someone reaches out to you 4 months later.
Not necessarily, because they don't always do it. They do it throughout the season.
Yeah.
So, like, they're doing it towards the end of the season, too. And even those newer entries still are just like, oh, no, I can't this season, but I just filled it out. Or just ghost me or something like that. So the percentage isn't that high. Like, we barely
fills out a free agent form.
Yeah.
And you touch base with them immediately, and then you keep in touch with them regularly.
Yeah. Well,
your engagement is going to be way higher. So that's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you give them even a couple weeks without any response or answer, it's going to fall off. So
we could try.
You're so negative.
I'll just tell you I told you so.
I love when me and Jerry argue. It's fun.
I'll just tell you.
This is one of those few points me and you always argue about.
Yes, because I deal with it.
We got a couple. I know you do. I'm trying to help you with that. That's
okay. Help me help you.
Yeah,
help me help you.
You.
All right, I love it.
Let's do some league updates. We got sidetracked. Sorry. All right. I want to do, like I said before, let's go through our regular like recap of this week, and then
can we go back because I got yelled at by a few people.
Rusty review.
Yeah, let's go back.
going far back, aren't we?
Yeah,
We didn't have games on.
We did the week before, or the
19th.
Yeah, we didn't.
That's because you just wanted to talk about the Beavers win, dude.
Dude, I got yelled at.
All right, fine, dude.
Got a few texts.
All right, so we're going all the way back to May 19th.
This was technically the beginning.
It was the beginning of that week.
The Santora episode.
It was. So the Dusty Beavers beat the South Jersey Raptors 11-3.
I mean, let's go. Who was the high point scorer there?
I don't know.
Let's fucking go, baby. All right,
so.
Come on.
I don't know, dude. Your name isn't on here. I see one goal for you.
Yeah, and three assists. 4 points, what up?
All right.
Go Beavers.
All right. So Beavers get their fourth career win. Right?
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. It doesn't happen often, so we have to really celebrate it when it does happen.
Did you do, when you did the top 10 for the showdown, did you do every team?
No, I just did.
You stopped?
Of course I stopped. You know how many, we have so many teams. Why would I do that?
It just would be funny.
Because here's the thing. There's not like a way to just do every season, every division. There's a way to do every division, which made it easier, but not every season. You have to go by season.
That's what he spends an extra 10 minutes, dude.
Dude, why would I go?
The Beavers would be at the bottom.
It would be at the bottom. Why would I do 40 teams for no reason when I know they're not even going to be close to the top five?
All right. Back to it.
I don't know. I'll put that up there.
The Yetis beat Moose Hockey 6-4.
Yeah. Yeah, great matchup there.
Shell Shaka's beat the Narwhals 3-0. I don't know why it says shootout.
I don't shootout. 3-0. But,
did they get a point out of that? South Jersey Corn Stars. I said Coin Stars.
Coin Stars.
Beat the Rusty Rollers 4-1. I think I ref that game.
You did. All relatively...
I got to fix this, I think.
Yeah, all relatively good games.
They were all pretty good games. I mean, there was a couple blowouts.
You know? Well, just ours. But other than that...
I don't know why it says that. So they're 1-1. That makes sense. Okay.
That's weird.
So, are we good?
So you saw... what games did you say? For the Rusty review? What games did you say?
He reffed.
Oh, other ones at Flyers Training Center.
Oh, okay.
So it was like... sorry, I gotta scroll all the way back.
It's okay.
I did the... Oops.
The Wolves versus the Corn Stars.
What am I doing here?
Right?
What the fuck is going on, bro?
It was...
You did Wolves, Corn Stars?
Yes. And I think Yetis and Moose.
And Moose, yeah.
Yes.
All right. So I had the lines drawn up on the wall behind us for the Beavers game.
Did you bring like a Sharpie?
No, they're just fucking writing all over the wall. So I put numbers up for the power play and penalty kill.
Nice, dude.
I think once we kind of took over the game a little bit towards the end, kind of just rolled the lines, but
yeah,
I think everyone was bought into the power play and penalty kill, special team stuff.
I think everybody agreed.
And we were able to get the lines together.
And then we switched the line third period.
You guys looked great.
Me and Boggy played offense.
Yeah, that was funny.
You got a goal there at the end, right?
Bogger did, yeah.
Bogger nice. Did. And an assist in that game. Look at that, dude. Yeah. That bronze work's paying off.
Yeah, the Beavers show up. Who do we got next? Yetis?
Yes.
I got to do my scout report.
Yes. Yeah, we got Yetis. And Steve will be there.
I will be reffing that game as well.
At the Flyers Training Center.
Let's go.
I got to, whatever. Yeah.
I'm thinking I'm ready to move up, dude.
Oh, yeah?
Just finish the season out.
What, Rusty?
Yeah.
I like it when you're a ref, like you kind of want to skate.
Yeah.
You can still skate.
I can't even imagine. Yeah. I feel like I would want to go out there and just skate around the whole fucking rink. So,
well, like, makes sense. There's something like when a play's breaking out and you have to keep up with it, it's nice. It's like you get your juices flowing.
Yeah.
Because you got to beat the play in, really. Yeah. And it would be nice to try to beat the play in for, you know, higher level.
Mm.
Got it.
You know, whatever. Yeah, all right. Whatever. So we will time travel forward to Tuesday, this past Tuesday. Monday and Sunday, we didn't have any games because Memorial Day.
Yep.
America.
Thank you.
Yep. So the Whale Watchers beat Knights Watch Silver 5-3. I watched some of that game. Whale Watchers got a lot of college guys.
Oh, yeah?
They were pretty good.
Was Robbie in net?
For Knights Watch?
Yeah.
I believe so.
I was just curious if Whale Watchers outplayed him or...
I don't remember if I even looked, dude. But I would assume so.
I'm just curious. They have 46 shots on net.
Yeah, Robbie. Yeah. So he had...
I just kind of know what to expect. That's all, man.
He still had a 90% save percentage, you know.
He's a freaking beast.
In a loss, but...
He is a staple on Hawks Gold. Like...
Yes.
MVP caliber.
I would imagine so. Yes. I wish he would play like that. You know, he played against the Hawks and Knights Watch Silver and won that game.
He plays like that 90% of the time.
He does, yes. It's so frustrating. He owes me a championship because of that motherfucker. All right. So, game of the week was Rain City and the Blue Chew Bulldogs.
What a game, dude.
Yeah.
You guys were there. I didn't watch it, so
we were there. Do it. It was a great game. Great back and forth. So many snipes.
No, it was really just me watching it like, fuck.
Like, this is high level.
Snipes. It's after snipes. After
two gold teams, pretty much.
Dude.
They're not necessarily good silver teams, but with some good gold players sprinkled in.
Yeah, of course.
So,
which is what silver is.
No, silver level, but just me thinking about our last few games. For the Hawks.
I have like a wicked glare coming in here. So like my whole right side of my body is lit up. Sorry.
Is it burning?
No.
I was just blinding. Just, I was looking at it from the way the Hawks have been playing and then watching these two go at it. I was like, fuck.
Yeah, they were good.
You know what though? Like even when we have, like we can go and lose to like one of the not like top teams. And then, but when we play against a good team, we tend to show up. We play much better when we play better teams, dude.
You know what's crazy?
We keep it tighter. We play like
You know what's crazy?
Teamwork. You know?
Yeah. Santora and Shuksta both had great games. Like, they were both playing really well.
Yeah.
I heard
that. I think, I don't know how it worked out, but Brian was also, or Santora was also mic'd up for that game.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm excited to see.
I guess Shuksta should probably have some content.
Oh, and watch. I already did. Did you upload the video?
Yeah. I just got it today. Or when you gave me the camera.
Yeah, yesterday. So, at the end, there's a little a little something funny that happened.
Okay.
And let's just say I got a little too intimate with what was going on with the Zoom.
Wait, did you say Brad already published?
He probably did. I think he posted on early in the week.
Oh, go check out Crawl Daddy Saves.
Yeah, man.
Cool. Yeah, it was a good game, though.
But yeah, watch Game of the Week until the very end. Gotcha. Until after the handshakes.
Or just, yeah.
We were cracking up.
All right. Glassberg Goop played the Stratosphere Stars.
He just wants to get through the scores.
I mean, God forbid we didn't talk about the Hawks for 30 seconds. Let's go. Keep going.
We're on pace here.
So the Stars, again, were up with less than probably a minute left.
He's so mad.
Even less. And gave up a tying goal at the end and then lost in overtime.
Boo.
The Goops, they're pretty good. They're young.
Sticky, sticky.
There's a lot of young teams, man.
That's good. Well, it's summer. Yeah, that's what you're going to get.
Yeah. So, all right.
That's my pick, Goop.
So, Otters played the Koopas. And
I also officially picked
Bulldogs.
If not the Hawks, the Bulldogs.
The Bulldogs.
For the Silver Cup.
Yeah, I could see that.
Well, then pick. Sorry. That's your final matchup.
Santora put a bunch of gold players. You know, they're like 80% gold players.
They're good.
I texted
80%.
He called me a hypocrite. I was like, hold on.
Not 80%.
I was like, I'm on that team.
They got a couple good players.
Otters beat the Koopas 9-5. Paisanos beat the Knights 4-3. Paisanos doing really well.
Forget about it.
Yes, sir.
That was a close game, though. Last night, the Warriors beat the Dad Bods 4-1.
Warriors.
Yeah, nice to see the Warriors in the win column.
Agreed. Let's go.
Down in bronze. Moonshine beat the Veritas Senators 5-4. There you go, Meatball, getting a Moonshine win.
I feel like every bronze plus game is close.
Yeah.
Everyone.
Yeah.
Like,
it was, yeah, every game that I've played in so far has been really close.
Even when I do the final, like when the final scores, they're always by like one or two goals.
Yeah.
So.
I'll tell you what about the Stars.
Bronze Plus is kind of lit.
Yes. No matter what, I think Jordan Haller is like the MVP of Bronze Plus, too, no matter what. Dude, like he keeps, and he wears like small pads. Dude.
I know.
He's got like, he doesn't take up a lot of space, but he's like.
Positioning?
Yeah. Honestly, if we didn't have.
Probably athletic.
If Stars didn't have Haller, we would lose by like five.
Yeah.
Every game, probably. So.
This next game actually surprised me a little
previous
bit.
MVP, yeah, former, yeah, MVP. Former MVP.
This next game surprised me a little bit.
The Chugs?
Yeah. Chugs are good.
Yes.
So are the Plugs.
Yes, Chuggernauts are really good.
They had a funny thing.
Big Chugs guy.
They,
Chugs and
Unplugged. Yeah, yeah, they're saying. Yeah, they unplugged the Plugs because they were undefeated. So gave them the first loss.
Some Chugs merch.
Chugs.
Hope they went slow. Chuggernauts win 6-1.
It's a butt joke.
Over the Plugs. Yes.
Oh. All right, Daddy.
So,
all right.
This is a interesting podcast. Dude. All right. So, this is Friday, May 31st.
Mad. Why are you so mad, Steve?
What? I'm just doing the thing.
Look how mad he is.
Yeah, he's mad.
All right. So, tonight we have the Narwhals taking on the Sugar Bush.
Let's go.
We have Hawks Bronze taking on the Tropics.
Let's go.
Yeah,
we're going.
Yes. Right after that,
are we going to be deep partners?
You're not playing defense, dude.
Who else is going to play?
It doesn't matter, but you're not. So, you said it yourself, dude.
I know, I can't be playing. Nobody else wants to play D.
We have defense.
Do we?
Yeah, me, Rob, Matt Angelo, and Chris Magnin's probably going to have to play D.
Okay.
Because we have, they have like 10 forwards.
Oh, do we? Oh, that kind of sucks. Okay.
Yes. So, three lines, you know. We'll bench you at the end.
Plus one. Yeah. I'll bench myself.
Nah, dude. Nah.
I'm scoring a goal tonight.
Yeah, you are.
Okay.
All right. South Jersey Invaders take on JMCC Auto. Invaders looking for their first win, but they were very close last week, and they're very close to first game, too. So for being a free agent team, that is pretty
I'm going to say the best looking free agent team, too.
Absolutely.
Let's just throw that out there.
Yes. That's my favorite set of jerseys so far. If we had another Jersey Madness, I think they would win.
Ooh, we got to do that. Maybe because there's a lot of new jerseys, new logos. Maybe in the fall we'll bring that back. Or no, we should probably
madness? No.
Why not?
I'm just kidding. I'm just
why not wait till March and then we'll do it then? We'll do it in the spring. So
now you're talking.
It kind of makes sense.
Now to you're
do
talking.
All right.
Can't all do you right. madness in the fall.
True.
Stupid.
That makes sense.
That's stupid.
And Shaka's brah.
Brah.
Play Jersey Shore Trash tonight.
Gonna be a good game.
Yeah.
Shaka'sBrah.com.
Yes. Do you want to do a Rusty preview?
Rusty preview.
For I mean, Sunday?
We're going to preview everything, right? So might as well.
Yes. So
Rusty exists.
Sunday, we have Dusty Bush playing the Rusty Wolves at Penn Soccer.
Ooh, Dusty versus Rusty. Rusty, I love it.
We have the Beavers play.
You think those wolves are going to eat those Bush, or what do you think? What do you think is going to happen?
We have the Dusty Beavers playing the Yetis. Dude. Wow, man.
That like went over my head for some reason.
It didn't go over my head. I got anyway. All right. Beavers play the Yetis.
Yes, Beavers play the Yetis.
How are you guys feeling, coach, player?
I think good.
Coach, captain.
Coach, captain. Yes. I think good.
I can't wait till you guys turn on each other.
No, we won't. Not on the ice. Nah, just about free agents.
I'm just kidding, dude. All right.
I think we're a different team.
Yeah,
we're a different team.
You need to convince Mark Rienzi to come back.
Yeah.
He'd be your ace in the hole.
Yeah.
Yeah. They are a different team. They're playing well.
They are playing well.
And I'm hoping we can, after the week off, you know, hopefully we can pick back up where we left off.
I hope so.
I think so. Everyone had off, so.
You guys were in the same boat. Goals. Yeah. I think the Yetis are a bit of a different matchup than the Raptors.
I'm going to fight the Yetis.
I'm going to
fight them all.
I'll be studying some film over the weekend. I'll drop the plan.
There you go.
See what you got to do. Maybe I'll lace them up.
Let's go. South Jersey Raptors take on the South Jersey Corn Stars.
South Jersey. Who put the South Jersey in front of the Raptors? Did you? Or did they?
Not me. They wanted it SJ Raptors.
Huh?
It was better than their first name.
What was it?
Something very provocative.
Oh. With Raptors?
Creamers. South Jersey Creamers. Something crazy, dude.
No. The Raptors, I'm saying. They wanted...
Who was the Creamers?
Probably the Corn Stars.
The Invaders were the...
I don't know what you're saying.
All right, never mind. I told you guys. You guys don't remember. Anyway,
talking about free agent teams.
I asked them to change their name. Anyway, so
chill? That it was probably, chill.
I think it was the Invaders. All right, and then Moose Hockey play the Narwhals on Sunday. That's the second game of the back to back at Flyers Training Center.
Okay.
All right.
Rusty,
old school rivalry, Moose Hockey Narwhals.
All right.
Oh boy,
you want to go into some standings?
Oh. Yeah, I do.
Standings, let's go.
I thought he was going to sneeze and bring
I want to go through our standings. I want to go through our standings, our stat leaders, and then I want to determine a game of the week for week four.
All right,
dude. So let's get the
standings. Take it easy, dude.
Let's get the standings done first.
All right, so the Chill are number one in goal, which is pretty cool.
New team? Yeah, I was looking, obviously, at the goal differential.
Positive eight.
Top three are really close. 24-7, I don't know what to say. I would pick them to win today.
They could be 0-6, and I probably would pick them
to win. Yeah.
So
we got a different look in the gold division.
We do.
Yeah.
Rain City Gold in second place at 2-0 as well. Knights Watch 2-0, 24-7 0-2, Armada 0-2, and Hawks Gold 0-2.
Welcome, 24-7. Glad to have you.
Down in the basement of gold. All right. So silver, it's not looking a ton different, but Rain City 3-0. But you know, look at the gold differential. It's nothing crazy.
Look at the Hawks, dude.
Jeez. Yeah, 3-0 last season would have been like a gold differential of like 20. So I think we're good, in good shape.
Oh, they've played three close games. I'm pretty sure
they have. So. Blue Chew Bulldogs 2-0-1 with that one OT loss versus Rain City. Whale Watchers also 2-0-1. So that's another new team. Militia 1-1. Multi Ducks 1-1. Night Swatch 1-2. And winless are the Hawks and the South Jersey Barracudas.
Yeah.
So we definitely got to get our goal stuff
differentials
together.
Again, really tight.
They are.
Across all 1 through 8.
Yes. Pretty much.
And the top three teams have a game in hand on us, so we're gonna bounce back.
That is true. One win makes a big difference, but it's going to be tight for those top four playoff spots.
I can't wait.
I know.
On a whole week.
I know.
With no games.
Yeah, you played this morning, though. So.
I had to.
Probably lit up all the everybody.
All the rusty
practice. I think I got that one-time snapper down, dude.
You did in the last Hawks game.
I went top cheddar today.
You? Oh, man.
Wow. Where the hell do you just learn these things? It just happens?
I don't know. Must I find nice when thing. I don't think about it, Skinny Larry having a nice things. Shot.
Nice.
But when I work on it, I
fuck it.
Or when I focus on it, I'm like, I fan on it or some shit. But all if right. I'm just like not thinking at all, just.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Nice. Must be nice, dude. All right. So.
It's like anything, dude. If you don't think about it.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah.
Kind of. All right. Bronze Plus, the Glassboro Goop are 3-0. Moonshine's in second. There's like four teams with 4 points. So Moonshine, Paisanos, Otters, and the Stars kind of right in that 2-5 spot.
Yeah.
Koopas, Knights, Veritas, Senators, and the Thundercats. Thundercats, defending champions, 0-2.
Yeah. Moonshine only has 2 games played. They're up in second place.
Yeah.
I think Bronze Plus is going to be.
But again, goal differential is not bad.
Last season, I was going to say that again. I don't want to keep bringing that saying up. But it. Five from number one down to nine.
Yeah, there's
a 10 difference of 10, which is crazy to me.
Same thing in silver. Yeah,
I think last
not a lot.
I think last was it last season where. Yeah, it was last season where Bronze Plus was like insanely close at the end.
Yes.
Yeah. And I think it's going to be the same way with this season.
Yeah, top five make it. 4 and 5 are playing as usual.
Yeah.
Bronze is a little different because there's so many teams, but we'll get to that.
Yeah.
Bronze, the Chuggernauts, 3-0.
Look at them.
Nice to see. With probably the best goal differential in the league,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, they're playing.
Yeah, they're pretty good. So, John Hood.
John Hood's.
Ah, yeah. John Hoodie.
Yeah.
Playing out of his mind.
30.
He's playing very well.
He's good.
He is very good. All right. So, Jersey Shore Trash in 2. That's pretty awesome, too.
Yes, sir.
Tropics.
2-0.
Tropics 3. Dad Bods 4. Plugs. Warriors. JMCC Auto. Another defending champ, but they're still in the mix. Mm-hmm. Shaka's Brah.
Brah.
.com. And then 9 through 13 are all all winless. But I will say... that it's again their differential is not bad, especially like I haven't played for the Hawks Bronze, but they've what 2-1 goal games that you guys lost by.
Yeah. So, basically,
yeah, could have went getting good. We need some goal scoring, but definitely one of the lowest goals against in Bronze. So Narwhals, Hawks Bronze, Sheep Hockey, and the Invaders 0-2.
You guys will collect some wins, I think.
I think so.
I think
we're still working kinks out.
Big game tonight.
Big game against a good team.
Yeah.
So, all hands on deck that one.
Let's go Hawks. Yeah. Baby.
Let's get tropical.
Please turn the Hawks franchise around.
I know we need something.
Oof.
All right.
0-6.
No, stop it. Okay.
Just saying. That's what they are. This is our third.
All
game.
Right, dude.
I'm just saying.
We get it.
We just saying.
Yeah, we get it, dude.
Just don't forget we're number 3 on that fucking wins list. So no disrespect coming this way.
I'm not. Bring up your I one note. Just, I will bring up my one note. I'm just saying we're gonna change that tonight.
All right,
let's go.
So Rusty, the Corn Stars. So they've only played 2 games. Some teams have only played 1.
Mm-hmm.
Corn Stars are in first at 2-0. Shell Shaka is 2-0 as well. Moose Hockey 1-1. Then we have Dusty Beavers,
let's go.
Yetis, and Narwhals at 1-1.
Yep.
Winless are Dusty Bush, Rusty Wolves, and the Raptors. Now, Dusty Bush and Rusty Wolves have only played 1 game.
Yep.
With a, again, low goal differential. I don't want to, like, we keep bringing that up, but everything's really tight.
But here's the thing. It matters. Goals matter. So you don't want to let up. You want to keep scoring because obviously it matters. That's what's the big deal here.
Yeah,
so that's why we keep bringing it up.
Of course. If you're losing, if you're losing.
Don't give up.
You keep scoring.
Yeah.
And if you're winning.
Keep scoring.
Keep scoring. Because, or at least defend.
Well,
because
I keep bringing it up because it represents how close
everything is.
Yeah, but I'm just saying.
I hear what you're saying, on the other end,
it can mean a playoff position.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you guys want to do 2 early playoff or predictions?
Championship predictions?
I'm down. I'm down. I've been trying to throw in who I think is going to win.
Here's the thing. You cannot pick your own team. Let's just say that.
I'm not picking my own team.
Okay.
Come on, man.
He's going to. It's going to be stupid. He's going to.
Because I, you know.
Fine. Then think about it. Pick who you're going to play against in the finals. Okay.
I'll just pick who I think is going to win.
Are you doing full playoff or just
champs?
Okay, so we'll get it on record. Champs. Let's go here. I love this.
Just too early.
Yeah.
Too early. So, you know, we don't have to stick to it, obviously. Right. For gold, I'm going to say 24/7. I'm going to just
Yeah.
I know they're 0-2, but come on.
I'm also going 24-7.
Come on, man.
24-7? That's easy.
Hey, what are you doing?
I'm going with our e-bug.
He doesn't even know, dude.
Rain City.
Well, ooh,
let's
e-bug.
Go.
E-bug.
Yeah, why'd you say e-bug?
For the Flyers?
Oh, yeah. Spencey.
Yeah, I don't know how he was a fucking free agent. But
I know. I thought he didn't want to play anymore.
On fuck Rain City.
I know, dude. That's a crazy pickup.
If he plays the whole season?
Yeah.
I'm going with Rain City. I'm not betting against him.
I know.
Let's go, Spencey.
I think they're going to be splitting time.
Oh, are they?
Yeah.
Who's their other goalie?
They have a couple, but they're kind of just like figuring that out. Yeah.
I mean, they're undefeated right now.
It's hard to find a gold goalie, but,
yeah, but
Spence is a good place to
start. They have the best goals against. So sure.
Absolutely, yeah.
Let's take that into consideration.
Yeah, right, man.
Now. So that's why I'm putting it on Rain City.
Okay. Silver, what do you think?
Sylvie.
I'm going Bulldogs.
Yeah.
I have my picks, but I'm going Bulldogs.
Yeah. If it's not the Hawks, I'll pick the Bulldogs.
I like doggies.
Doggies.
Wow.
Too early. All right, Bronze Plus.
Goop.
Goop?
Goop, okay.
Goop.
I'm going to say, if not the Stars, because I actually do believe if the Stars can, you know, get it going, very hard to beat. But if I'm not picking the Stars, it is Paisanos.
Ooh. I was thinking Paisanos.
Paisanos.
I was legit thinking the Paisanos.
No, you weren't.
Right. I was.
You going with Paisanos?
No, because I don't want to do the same thing as everybody else. You know what?
Jesus.
You know what? I'm giving Meatball some credit here.
Okay. Now, that's one I would love to see.
Yeah, let's go Moonshine.
I would love to see that, too.
Let's go Moonshine.
All right. Bronzies.
Ooh.
I hate to keep picking the top team, but I'm going Chuggernauts.
Nah.
You're picking Chuggies?
Yeah.
Nah.
Been saying that for a couple weeks. Just saying.
I'm gonna go reigning champs, JMCC Auto.
Think they're repeat?
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Think they're good. They're very good for bronze. So.
Wow.
Yeah. Did you pick one, Jerry?
No, not yet. Oh yeah, Chugs are good. They've got, look at their goals for.
Yeah, they're scoring a lot.
Oh my god. And it's hard. Yeah, it's hard to pick against them with hooding goal and then goals for. So,
yeah. All right.
Yeah. Okay. Chugs.
Dead air.
All right. Rusty.
You know what? Sometimes let them. It's anticipation.
It's true. It's true.
All right. Rusty.
He's got a point. This one actually, I don't know. To be honest with you, I'm not sure.
Beavers.
I want to pick the Beavers.
I am going to go with probably the Corn Stars.
Yeah,
they're the best all around team. That's what it comes down.
They're deep.
Yeah,
like they're
and they got a great goalie.
They do. I don't think there's anybody who's above Rusty level. Maybe questionable. Like there's I know one guy, but he plays plays defense. He's just got a hard shot. That's Tyler.
Yeah, one goal against.
Yeah, so, but the most always like, because I've kind of seen them watching them the both games. And they just kind of, they're just more complete throughout the lineup.
Yeah.
That I feel like that goes a long way in Rusty. Because they don't have any, like, beginners. Yeah. Like, true beginners. They have all Rusty guys, but there are no true beginners on that team. So, there's not a lot of weaknesses.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go with the Moose.
Mooseies?
Yeah.
All right. Come on, Rusty guy.
The Beavers against who in the finals?
Yeah, Beavers against Corn Stars because I want a rematch.
All right. That was actually not that bad of a game.
It wasn't, and it was our first game, but...
Yeah.
And I should have had two goals.
Yes, you should have.
I'm very upset. I'm still upset about
Glory
this.
Guy over here.
I'm still upset. Well, yeah.
Yes.
But I hate shutouts. I hate shutouts more than I hate losing.
Fair enough.
That is frustrating.
It's very frustrating.
So
he's a good goalie, but I hate that.
All right, so we're going to move on to stats. Now, we have all new faces in the stats, which is very surprising.
I had a feeling. I didn't look at them, but I had a feeling.
It is very surprising.
Half or quarter away? Quarter of the way through?
It's crazy. We have Billy Basco from the Koopas, 11 points.
Basco.
Chris Giletto. You know him.
Yeah, I do.
Is it Giletto or Giletto?
Giletto.
Giletto, 11 points.
Like
and
the ice cream?
That's gelato. Dimitri from the Bulldogs has 9 points. Kyle Young is kind of like a, you know.
He's a staple.
Yep. Peters from the Bulldogs, Kevin Magna from the Knights, also a Hawk. This guy's very good. Julian. Jeez, why does everybody have weird names, dude?
I would say Boyclair.
Boyclair?
Boyclair.
It's definitely like French, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Boyclair.
Yeah, dude. So, you know, Chris Giletto leads in goals. He's got 7 goals, but I don't see any. I don't see Ross Bryan. I don't see Huffnagel. I think at the end of the season they're going to be up there, but like
100%.
But
I mean, I think we should get to points per game.
But at least right now.
Yeah, oh, are you Jesus, out there? Oh, oh my god!
Oh god!
Look at him, the picture and all.
Let's go.
So Sean Aitken from the Warriors has 6 points per game, but Jerry Cota-Petis,
this is unbelievable,
has
dude.
4 points per game.
This is
how many games you played?
Two.
All right, 8 points in 2 games.
Let's go. Boy. No, we had a shutout the first one. I don't know why it said 4 points per game, but
that's actually
how many points do you have?
I had 4 points in 1 game.
So it's not calculating right?
Yeah, it doesn't sound like it. But
So there's some weird shenanigans going on, huh?
It doesn't matter.
Shenanigans.
4 points. Oh, it's only showing you as 1 game played.
Why?
You probably didn't get checked in the first one.
Oh.
So drop that down to 2.
I know.
Game. You're way out of there now, dude. I just,
all right. It's nice seeing my name up there.
But yeah, I thought that was cool, man.
That's funny.
Different. John Hood has 3 wins. Shuksta has 3 wins. Christian Graham is 2. I know that their save percentage, Brian Leeds for the Corn Stars, is 97. He's only letting 1 goal.
Yeah.
And then Adam from Shell Shockers as well. A different Brian Leeds. Is that?
That's the same guy.
Oh, did he play for
he
the?
He played for the Goop, yeah. He played for the Glassboro Goop.
Against? Okay.
Yeah.
I didn't even notice that was him.
Yeah.
All right. Jordan Haller, 94% save percentage. And then I know Ryan Savage for Paisanos.
Is really playing good. Bronze Plus and Rusty.
Who?
Brian Leeds is the Corn Stars goalie, yeah.
But is it different?
He subbed in for the Goop. The Goop have a sick goalie, I'm pretty sure, but that was their sub.
I gotcha. But okay.
Goop
only scored bronze, 1 goal on him.
Yeah, Goop is Bronze Plus, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you could play it 1 up, 1 down. So if Brian Leeds is a bronze level goalie, you can play 1 up, you can play 1 down.
Yeah, but that's he's doing good.
he is good. I'm sure
he is
having good. A bronze level goalie in Rusty is good.
Yeah,
it's a good thing.
Yeah. Yes,
for sure. All right, so that's that.
Yeah, plus he reached out to us too. I mean, he joined as a free agent.
He wanted
he's
to play
been wanting
up.
To like work his way
he,
up.
Yeah, he wants to play up. So yeah. I don't know if
he'll make his way up.
Yeah, getting some subs in.
Yeah, I think Santoro was trying to like find him another spot too.
Yeah, he's good. He's a good goalie.
Yeah.
Game of the week here. I want to get bronze involved. The problem is, I feel like every week a bronze plus game could be picked. But I'm looking at Jersey Trash and Chuggernauts. But that's Friday night, 9 p.m. at the NHL rink. You guys are playing 9:55.
What is it?
Jersey Shore Trash and Chuggernauts Friday night.
Yeah, we'd have to get like Photo Bob to do that.
Yeah, Rob or Bob.
Rob's gonna be playing.
Oh yeah. Can we do? We'll have to talk about this another time. But Hollydale has a spot, right? To film or no?
It would have to be not for us.
Okay.
But
yeah, we'll talk about that another time.
So Corn Stars and Yetis. That sounds like a good game.
Corn Stars Yetis, huh?
Mm-hmm. And that's at Flyers Trading Center.
8:25.
Wait, that's technically not this week though. That's next week.
Oh yeah. Okay, so, I gotcha. Because yeah. they loaded up that week. Okay.
Well, yes and no, because we had off this week, so we're still in the third week. I know you don't want to have this conversation all the time.
He's gonna lose his mind.
I know he's gonna lose his mind, but it's our fourth game.
This week.
Fourth game.
All right.
Dave. If we're looking at Rusty and Moose. Moose Narwhals. Bush Wolves.
He's in the wrong week.
All right, dude. Oof. Jesus. I'm just looking through.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I was trying to pick one. We can establish it.
Yeah, we'll figure that out. Yeah. All right.
I got a couple selections for you guys.
I don't like any of them.
I don't like you.
All right, cruising right along here. Quick shout out to our Silver Division sponsor, the North Hockey, who's helping us work towards providing the community with unique opportunities to experience the world through ice hockey. Go check out more of what they do on Instagram with @TheNorthHockey. While you're at it, make sure to follow @InsideTheU and subscribe here on our YouTube channel. We'll be doing a lot more behind the scenes, community stuff, and program announcements and or updates over there. Find everything I just mentioned with the links in our description. Reminder, you golf outing.
Ooh, yes.
September 16th. Registration is live. Any quick thoughts on that?
No, I'm excited for it.
Head over to the page, check it out, see what's going on.
Yeah. And UHOHockey.com/golf.
UHOHockey.com/golf. Nice. Stay tuned for more.
Pretty logo up there.
Beautiful logo, beautiful video.
You can register your foursome. You can watch the video from last year, which was really fun.
Yeah, it was.
Sorry, Jerry. I updated the points per game, and now you are not in there.
Also, look out for new merch drops and for the new teams. Updates to the teams are coming very, very, very soon, perhaps when you hear this episode. If you are looking to gear up now, or if you're looking to gear up and your team's not on there, hit up the contact page, and we'll get you updated. Don't forget, UHL Customs is live as well. Grab custom on and off ice merch there. Reminder that if you get new jerseys through there during the season, we'll get you guys set up with a complimentary shoot, compliments of photo Rob. So on to the commissioner's notes, if you have any.
Sorry. I don't. Okay. We already talked about summer series. Yeah. You know, get a team in if you want to get your team in. If not, you're dead to me.
Yes, sir. Our reminder, go check out our new contact page, UHL, and your facility. Cool video up there. Share it with your friends. And the updated gallery is in progress, but there are games uploaded. Go check it out. If not, stay tuned.
Yep.
Rob and Bob are cooking. So that's all I got, boys.
Nice.
Unless you got anything else, check out last week's interview with the unicorn, Brian Santor, with the link in the description.
Yeah.
Great epi. Shout out to my favorite comment from last week from Tyler Shoemate. He said, watching Jerry explain the category makes my brain hurt. Yes. And I couldn't agree more.
Like I said, well, couldn't be any clearer. Couldn't be any clearer.
If you have any feedback for the U Crew, drop a... What did I just say? If you have any feedback for the U Crew, drop a comment on YouTube and please continue sharing the show. We appreciate all your help so far and something as small as sharing this episode contributes to growing UHL as a whole. So
we are up to 853 views for the unicorn. That's all I got,
boys. The unicorn.
Nice.
Buzzing.
One of our biggest podcasts.
Buzzing. Cooking.
For Santora, dude? I'm just kidding.
I love it. What was that?
Fun interview.
Yeah, it was very fun.
Good, not great.
Brad did 8:32.
Yeah. So
Shit.
We're eclipsing that.
Yeah. So, wow.
Love it.
All right. Shout out to Brian Santor.
Yeah, man.
The unicorn.
Shout
out to you all. Adios. That's all I got.
All right, guys.
That's all I got. All right. Big game tonight. Big game Sunday. Yes, it'll be fun.
All right. See you guys.
See you. Bye.
Bye.